Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to be going over What If Leland Turbo Was Never Killed, suggested by Kirby Tankson, the Epic Cars Gamer. Honestly, thank you, Kirby Tankson, the Epic Cars Gamer, for today's suggestion. I really like it, and this is going to be a great episode 4. So, that's why I decided to suggest it today. It's pretty good. There's a lot of things that will make Cars 2 very short and different if Leland Turbo was never killed or found. Mainly we're just talking about killed, because obviously, as you know, he got compacted into a big box by Acer and Grimm, but they never showed it because that would be a little too inappropriate for a kids movie. So without further ado, let's get right into what would have happened. So Finn and Nissel will be actually in the boat currently, heading to the oil rig to see what's happening with the lemons and to check in for Leland Turbo. He'd eventually see Tony Trihole, the big villain boat number 2, to tell the boat that Finn McMissil was originally on to turn around. So Finn McMissil would crawl on or grab on to the boat and go straight to the oil rig, as Tony Trihole does not know. Finn McMissil would eventually get into the oil rig on one of the stands that's holding it up and start driving all the way up there. He start talking to Leland Turbo on the walkie-talkie or something like that, what they have in the Cars universe, and saying, Leland, this is Finn. I'm at the rally point. Over. And Leland would respond this time. He tell Finn that they have all the info on the camera already and there's no need for him to take pictures. Then they'd start running away on the water. They'd eventually find Holly Shiftwell, but since, in this situation, Leland actually escaped, and Finn, with all the info, without the lemons knowing, what would have happened is they wouldn't have been at the party anytime soon, or necessarily Miles Axelrod's speech. They wouldn't be there anytime soon. So Holly would go into the men's bathroom and gather all the info about who's behind the cameras and the lemons, the head of the lemons. They'd eventually bust Miles Axelrod, the person who was behind everything. He was the head of the lemons, and he was the one who would have put the bomb on Mater. But in this situation, that would have never even happened. So they bust Miles Axelrod, not at London, but they bust them in Tokyo. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys later.